See what these ravens do to me? You see how they stress me out? They made all my hair fall out. Anyway, YouTube team, keep it clean. Tonight is the night before the game, but you'll be seeing this on the morning of the game. It's been a crazy Saturday. Of course, the biggest story that came out from the Ravens today was that Lamar Jackson, Adam Schefter just said like an hour ago that he's 50-50 to play, but the Ravens added Lamar Jackson to their injury report after taking him off of the injury report, after he was on the injury report before that, and it's just been back and forth. But apparently he has some symptoms, some like flu-like symptoms and whatnot. Maybe he could have his own flu game, but hopefully ain't the same flu game that Jordan had, because Jordan really didn't have the flu. It was, anyway, we don't need to talk about that. That's a whole nother conversation for a whole nother day. So if I'm already looking at this game like Lamar is not playing. I'm already, all right, Tyler Huntley mode has been activated in my mind already. But if Lamar plays, great. If he doesn't play, okay, cool. We rolling with Tyler Huntley. And don't sleep on Tyler Huntley, because the man can play. He can ball. We've seen it before quite a few times. He's gotten his most extensive playing time in the preseason. But I know it's going to be a lot of people like, oh, man, he did it against backups. He only did it in the preseason. Well, like I always say, when people try to downplay when people have good games in the preseason, what if those same people had bad games in the preseason? Then I would understand, okay, yeah, right, we could have that conversation. But he played good in the preseason. And he played really good. Now, with him, with Tyler Huntley, excuse me, if he's going to be playing quarterback tomorrow, and especially with Hollywood being out, I feel like that will give the other receivers a big opportunity. Hollywood's out. Miles Boykin, he is out. So you're going to have Bateman. You're going to have Sammy Watkins. You got Prochet, DuVernay, and Tylan Wallace. Tylan Wallace may get his first NFL catch tomorrow, maybe. Because, again, Ravens are down receivers. So he this might just be his chance to get his first catch. We'll see. But with Tyler Huntley, he, since he works, we talked about this before, since he works with the twos could really have a big advantage to step up tomorrow. This could be their biggest opportunity of the year, really. Because we know Lamar, when he's on the field, he's looking for Hollywood, he's looking for Andrews, and he got a good rapport with the other receivers like Bateman and whatnot, and Sammy Watkins. They got a good chemistry. But you know, Lamar, his focal point is usually Hollywood. He got big trust for Hollywood. But now with Tyler Huntley, I feel like there's not that sort of loyalty if he's going to end up playing. So I feel like he may end up spreading the ball around that much more. So we'll just see how it all works itself out tomorrow. Now, one thing that was very interesting, because you know Ravens made a lot of roster moves on Saturday. They made a lot of changes and whatnot. But at the running back position, Latavius Murray is back. But with Latavius Murray being back, and Devontae Freeman, I would expect him to still run with the ones, even though they don't have a clear-cut starter. I would hope that they would really let Devontae Freeman be the lead back. Let's do that, Ravens. But they did not activate Nate McCrary. So the only three backs that you have are a healthy Devontae Freeman, a Latavius Murray that this is his first game back from injury, so how healthy is he? He's healthy enough to play, but how healthy is he? And you got Tyson Williams. Could this be a... I'm not going to count on it, but we'll see tomorrow. We'll see. We'll see today when you're seeing this. Mark Andrews last week. He had a decent game last week. He ain't like go off anything like that, but he got a touchdown and whatnot. He had a couple nice catches and whatever. But now let's double that. Let's double that. Again, whether it's with Lamar, whether it's with Huntley, whoever's gonna be with, let's double that. Now in this game, Mekhi could be back. Ben Cleveland could be up. So if we can get that strength on the offensive line, and if Mekhi is 100, if Ben Cleveland is 100, if those guys are ready to go, it would be nice if that offensive line could be bolstered, because they need it desperately. Whoever the quarterback is, I don't care if Patrick Mahomes was back there. I don't care if Brady was back there. I don't care if Aaron, I don't care whoever, whatever quarterbacks are back there. Quarterback could be as good as they want to be, but if they ain't got no offensive line, it ain't going to work. It is not going to work. So, hey, if those guys play tomorrow and they're good to go, oh, man, offensive line could be so much. It all has so much potential. And that's my biggest thing. I've had so many conversations with different people. That's the biggest thing, in my opinion, that's the Ravens' biggest issue is their offensive line. Biggest issue, bigger than any defensive miscommunications, bigger than when the defense wasn't tackling, bigger than the pass rush, or whatever pass rush we got, bigger than, not necessarily bigger than injuries, but that's the biggest issue right now, is the offensive line. And if they can get the offensive line, if it could be a unit, a strong unit, then, oh boy, the sky is the limit. It really is. Now, with the defense, I'm not sure if Allen Robinson is going to play or not. We'll see. But the defense, communication got to be on point. It has to be. In the Dolphins game, that was their downfall because they would give up those big. And it's been all year, really. All year. Literally from week one, guys have been running wide open. Wide open. The communication has been off bad. This would be a great game to really get it built up. Now with Justin Fields, again, we know pass rush is everything. Justin Houston, so many Justins in this game, but Justin Houston, he made a really good point about the pass rush. He said when you rush Justin Fields, you got to be smart about it because you don't want to get too upfield to where you end up running past him. And then he's like, okay, bye, see ya. I'm out. Like the end of these videos. No, you got to be very smart, and you have to be very efficient with it too. So we'll see what Wink has drawn up tomorrow for Justin Fields. Now Wink has normally done pretty good. Ravens usually do pretty good against rookie quarterbacks. Justin Fields, man, he's something, man. Because my first time getting to really watch him, and I didn't get to see the whole game, but I saw more toward the end, was in that Steelers game. And I was like, oh, okay, this guy, okay, he can make some stuff happen. So with the Bears, with the whole team, they, again, we said it about the Dolphins, we said it about the Lions, we said it about the Vikings. These teams, they are so close. They are so close to having winning records, to winning games, but they end up crumbling at the end. Now, with these teams that have these bad records, so they are considered bad teams, you cannot let them hang around. Ravens cannot let the Bears hang around. Bears are going to be playing at the crib. They're going to be well-rested, even though I think at after their last seven bye weeks, so even before Matt Nagy. So after their last seven bye weeks, they're 0-7, something crazy like that. They got like some crazy bad record with their recent bye weeks, and I think that's wild. But this, we're sort of evenly, not necessarily evenly matched, we're sort of evenly matched. Actually, the Ravens might, well, no. Yeah, no, the Ravens, since they played on Thursday. But the Bears, they had their bye week, and the Ravens, they played on Thursday, so they had a little 10-day break. The Bears had a little 14-day break, but it's all good. There's no like, oh my goodness, this is so unfair. Nah, nothing like the Browns. We play the Browns and then they got it by weekend. Then we play the Browns again. And while we play the Browns, then we play the Steelers, then we play the Browns. I'm like, whoa. Who's mad at the Ravens? Who in the NFL is mad at the Ravens this year? Jeez, that was crazy. But yeah, they got to get after Justin Fields. They have to. And you can't let him get into a rhythm. The middle of the field has to be protected at all costs. He's a rookie quarterback, so he's going to try it. He's going to try those Ravens corners. People have been trying those Ravens corners all season long. People are not scared of Marlon Humphrey. People are not scared of Anthony Avery. People are not scared of the Ravens secondary. This Ravens defense, it doesn't scare people anymore. It really doesn't. So whether it's a veteran quarterback, whether it's a rookie quarterback, they are going to try it. That's why communication has to be on point. Tackling has to be on point. Because it's going to be cold up there. It's going to be super cold up there in Chicago and it's windy. Ugh, that weather just makes me sick. That's probably why Lamar got sick, because he was thinking about that weather. compared to down here in South Florida. That is so gross. But tackling, like when you tackle somebody in the cold, like you feel every hit that much more. But so do they. So Ravens, in this game, you gotta tackle and tackle well. Because if you're tackling, and if you're tackling well and you're tackling consistently, then them Bears, the offensive players, they gonna feel it. And they ain't gonna wanna take no hits. So then you start getting it. Then that's where the mental part comes in too. That's where the mental part comes in. And I feel like since I got a bald head, y'all can almost see what I'm thinking right now. But that's where, like, if you keep hitting them, keep tackling them and whatnot, then that's when guys, they start turning around before they actually catch the ball, because they start, like, oh, looking for that big hit. They're like, oh, no, it's coming. Oh, no, I don't want to get hit. So it should be a good game. I'm not expecting any blowouts, man. Ravens, like, you should expect the unexpected with them, but I ain't expecting any blowouts. Whether it's with Lamar, whether it's with Tyler Huntley, this Ravens team, it's so weird that, because every time you think you got this Ravens team figured out, all right, this is how this game is going to go, because we just noticed that they do something that just completely flips the script, and it's like, what? Where did that come from? I do expect them to bounce back. I do expect them to get the win. Now, if they win against Chicago, will it really be that impressive? Hopefully they make it impressive to where it's like, oh, okay, hey, that's the Ravens that we want to see. Now, of course, a win is a win, and I will always take an ugly win over a pretty loss any day of the week. But so however the Ravens got to get it done, how are they going to get it done? They need to get it done, because you don't want to find yourself at 6-4. While that's not the worst record in the world, it certainly wouldn't be the best, and it certainly wouldn't be good as you go into the hardest part of your schedule. This Bears game, this game right here, this is the easiest game, and I don't even think it's going to be easy, but this is the easiest game that's left on the Ravens schedule. This Bears game. And it's not even easy. Because you have the Browns, you have the Browns, you have the Steelers, you have the Bengals, you have the Steelers, you have the Packers, and you have the Rams. So it only gets so much tougher from here. So if you can't afford, but yeah, you can't afford to lose this game. You can't. It will put you in such a bad spot. Now in this game, I know this week, Greg Roman's been all the whole talk of this week. And I can understand why. It wasn't all on Greg Roman. Some was on Lamar. Some was on the offensive line. Some was on the receiver. It's a lot of everybody who was to blame. But I said this in a video previously, and I say it again here. I do believe, I don't want this scenario to even happen, but I do believe if the Ravens offense like fails this game, and especially if they lose, they better not lose. Ooh, you better not lose, Ravens. But if the Ravens offense fails this game and they lose, I do think Greg Roman could be fired. And the reason I say that is because on Thursday night, the world saw what happened. They saw the Ravens offense. And while Greg Roman is not entirely to blame, there's been so many consistencies throughout this year with Ravens offense, and even dating back to last year, and even the year before, even though they've been nicely ranked and whatnot, they've been one of the top offenses overall. But you see these little things that's like, oh, that's gonna come back to bite us. Oh, that's not good. They gotta fix that. But these things still have not been fixed. And come playoff time, that's where those things get exposed that much more. But with him having been put on the national spotlight on that after that Thursday night game, I do think I hope it doesn't happen. I don't want it to happen, because that would mean that the Ravens lost. But I really do believe that he could be fired if the Ravens were to drop this game and the offense just does a really bad job. If they were to lose this game and they score 45 points, and then no. But if they were to lose this game and they score like 12 points, 13 points, something like that, then So I feel like it's a lot riding on this game. And like we've said, we've kept saying, and it feels like it every single game. Like every Ravens game is so important. Every single one. Every Ravens game this year has been a big game. Literally every single one. From week one to now, everyone has been a big game. So hopefully these guys, they end up getting the win. We'll see how this thing goes. I am very nervous for this game. I mean, I'm really nervous for all Ravens games, really. It's crazy because for the Lions game, I remember for that one. Early in the week, I wasn't really nervous for it. But as the week went on and we got closer and closer and closer and closer, I started getting nervous about it because I'm like, oh, I know these Ravens, man. They just love stressing you out. They love stressing you out. But, yeah, we'll just see how it plays out. Team, keep it clean. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. One last thing before I get out of here. Kind of sad news, but I got some other important stuff to take care of today. But there will be no live stream today. There'll be no live stream today. So for the people that watch this entire video, I appreciate you watching it. So when it's time, when it's 1 o'clock and you don't see a stream, well, you know why. No stream today for the game. I love y'all. I appreciate y'all. And I will see you when I see you, because it won't be during the game, unfortunately. So we out.